Good afternoon, members of the commission and the members seated in the audience. My name is Ishwaran. I am from Ishwaran Brothers Exports. We are in the tea exports for the last 55 years. So I have come here to present to you some serious difficulties that are faced by the exporters. At the outset, I want to tell you I am not mentioning these facts to increase the profitability of the exporters. Because if there is more margin, there are 100 exporters. One man will reduce 50 cents, another man will reduce 1 rupee. Finally, it will come to the same level where the normal profits are held. Now, you know the importance of tea, I don't have to tell you. The most important thing we have to note, between last year and this year, there is a drop of 38 million kilos of tea in the exports. So that means we have to look at things in a serious way. Export of tea today is now basically depending on the tea bags. Everybody wants a tea bag because people have become lazy, they just want to drop the bag and drink the tea. And in Sri Lanka, in the 1970s, if I remember correct, the government, the tea board, took a decision, every tea bagging machine you import, 50% will be subsidized by the government. I must tell you, because of that decision, in our country today we have the highest number of tea bagging machines and we stand in a leading position in the world exports of tea bags. Now, in the times are changing, as you know, everything is changing. The type of teas preferred by the consumer has also changed and it will change further. Today everybody is looking for cheaper teas, and they don't want to, but however big we may say that our tea is pure Ceylon tea, they say, what's your price? That is the question they are asking. So if the exporters don't give a competitive price, we cannot export our teas. So to make things competitive, what are the things the government can do? I just want to bring one thing. In the tea exports now, our Sri Lankan tea prices are become very expensive. For example, I am just telling you, the PF Phoenix, which is costing about $2.5 to $3.5 at the Colombo auctions, is only costing $1.75 to $2 in India. So you can judge the difference. Even though there may be a difference in quality, but how much will people go for quality? How much can they afford? Maybe the Western countries, yes, they can afford such high prices. They must be wanting flavory teas, very special teas. But let us look at the 75% of the market. They are concerned on price. Can you give me at this price? Others are offering at $2 a kilo in tea bags. Can you offer that price? Okay, you may say that your tea is very superior. Okay, I'll pay you 10 cents more. Can you offer at that price? But with the Sri Lankan teas, we cannot offer at those price levels. So if we have to be competitive, what is the thing that we can do? We have to bring the cost of the tea down. How can we do that? We can do that by importing cheaper varieties of tea, mixing it with our tea and offering it to them so that our tea also will be competitive with other origins. Now in doing this, we have to import tea. Now there are so many restrictions on the, even though it is allowed, There are so many restrictions on the tea imports. When we have so much of problems, for example, one thing, the import valuation committee meets only once a week, that is on a Thursday. So we have to wait. If we miss one Thursday, we have to wait for one whole week to get our permit, because they have to approve that. Now, if that Thursday happens to be a holiday, then it will shift to the following week. So that means 2 weeks holidays are gone. And as you know, today everybody wants everything fast. Can you ship it in 1 week's time? Can you ship it in 3 days' time? These are the questions today we have been asked. But we are unable to do it because we need faster service from the government. This, if it can be made more frequent than the 1 week and Thursday only, it will be very helpful to the tea exporters. The second thing I would like to say is, we import herbs. Sometimes these herbs are mixed with tea and shipped. Sometimes they are packaged as it is and shipped. Well, that is good business for us, because the tea comes in, the herbs comes in free. We have to do only the packaging and ship it, and we get paid very well, I should say. Because of problems faced by the traders in Europe, because it's very costly for them to do that, they're sending it to Sri Lanka, asking us to package it and ship it back to them. Now, we don't lose anything in that. But when those teas come, we have a time in having them approved. Because the standards, European standards and Sri Lankan standards do not match. They differ. So when we go by, our people go by our standards, the European buyer says it has been passed by our customs, our laboratories, how can you say that it is not fit? So we have a big problem. Their goods are held up here because they pay the money and send it here, and they expect us to put it into tea bags and ship it back. If we are unable to do, and if it is delayed, they are very, very concerned about the whole thing. Now, when we have to reduce the cost of our tea, the only way is we import cheaper teas from other origin, mix it with Sri Lankan tea, and export it, re-export it. Now, if we can't do that, now there are a lot of regulations and permits and delays in doing it. So what happens? Now, I cannot satisfy my buyer because I can't give it to him at his price. Even if I can, there is a long delay in getting approvals from the concerned authorities. So what happens now? I can't lose the business I'm getting. So what do? I have to go to a place where I can import tea from Sri Lanka, import tea from any origin I want, whatever standard it is, mix it and then export it from there. I make my money. Because I have 500 people, I have to feed them, I have to keep them, I have to run an office, there are overheads. So I have to find business somehow. So what happens? The exporters are gradually shifting their operations to other countries, especially to India and Dubai. There are other places also where they operate, but they shift because it is easier. You go under their duty-free zone and put up your machines and import from anywhere, import from Sri Lanka, import from China, Vietnam, Burma, anywhere, and you export your tea. So that is the only way in which an exporter can survive. So what are we actually doing? By keeping all these regulations, we are allowing our own exporters to go to other countries and operate from there. There is no other way that we can do this. And we are trying to hold on to the statement, pure Ceylon tea. Now that is time ago, long time ago, that we held this pure Ceylon tea. But now, nobody asks us, can you ship pure Ceylon tea? No, they ask you whether you can ship tea. This standard, this color, this is what we want. So where is the concept of pure Ceylon tea? Just to hold that concept, a whole list of regulations are placed on the exporter. I am pleading that they have a review of this. Otherwise, day by day, that exporters will have to, they have no other option. What will they do with a big office here, factory here? They have to shift it.
Mr. Isaram, that the only and main reason for that is the unnecessary and all this regulation.
Yes. If the regulations are simplified and if they say, okay, you are a regular exporter, you have been in the tea trade for 50 years, more than 50 years, there are no black marks on you, we will allow you. Something like that. Today, a new person who enters the market and a veteran tea exporter like you know, Merrill J. Fernando or Akbar Brothers or ourselves, we are not given any difference in the playing field because we are treated in the same way. But we have struggled, we have earned today, and we are looking at ways and means how we can keep this in our country.
But the reason for these authorities, I can remember that when I was in the ministry institution, okay, the main argument that the tea board and others are saying that to maintain our quality of Sri Lanka tea, they are maintaining a lot of regulation. What do you think about that? To maintain the quality.
Today nobody is, now I'm an exporter, I ship to 59 countries. Nobody is asking me for pure Ceylon tea. They are asking me for tea. They know that it is from Sri Lanka and they don't ask me to put in the packet also. Earlier there was a regulation. You have to put in the packet pure Ceylon tea. Now there is no such requirement. And they also don't want it. They say, can you give me?
You put blended Ceylon tea.
So how are the exporters, how can they move forward with this type of conditions? I'm just mentioning a few for your information.
You export cinnamon now, sir? Cinnamon?
No, we do only tea. Only tea. When we import these herbs, our people. Pardon?
What are those herbs that get from abroad and you package them?
Yes.
Medicinal herbs?
Medicinal herbs. Some are mere perfume, some are health, mostly health, 90% health.
From which country do you get them down?
Germany, France, they are the people.
German herbals, why do they send it here? They can
powder
and put to
cracks. Yeah. They powder it and send it in bulk to us. They say now send it in 50 tea bags a packet, ship it. So we do it here because it is very, very costly for them to do it there.
Because like to tea bags.
Yes.
So
yes.
They put in water and drink like that.
Yes, correct.
Like herbal drinks,
exactly.
So they are sent from Germany and which country?
Germany, France, Spain, all countries. Wherever they can't, they feel that the cost is very high, they send it to us to do it because paper is cheap, board is cheap, labor is cheap, and we take good care of their product. For example, if somebody sends me 1 ton of herbs, we see that the entire 1 ton or 750 kilos are shipped. We tell them, look, we have shipped 750 kilos. That is what is required for your shipment. We have with us 250 kilos. Do you want us to keep it or ship it back to you? So that type of integrity, the Sri Lankan exporters have established.
But you are not taking that abroad. No, that is kept here.
That is kept here. Depending on the buyer, if they say, no, you send it to some other country or send it back to us, because some herbs are very valuable. 1 kilo is about $30, $35.
So thank you very much, Mr. Ishwar. Interesting discussion on problem free trade faces now.
Thank you.
And I want to tell only one more thing, just a couple of minutes. We also have problems with regard to VAT.
VAT.
Yes. Earlier, we had this SVAT, where we didn't have to block our money. Now you have changed it to VAT, which means our money will be blocked 13% to 15% upright, and to get it back, you know how long it is going to take.
How old is your VAT claims?
Pardon?
How old is your VAT claims now?
Now it is only recently, but as it goes
as
on.
Previous ones?
Previous ones, maybe 6 months.
6 months.
So it's the exporters' finances are
tied up. Authorities is even under the amnesty system. That can't be a problem. That is their interpretation. Of course, I also agree with you. This as a person who has to deal with the such systems, that is a very easy for exporters. But still, that has not decided. I think the Prime Minister is also involved and it is postponed. But even though you. Answer is that with the remit system, this refund process will be easy. But the question is not the refund process, but when the money goes to this treasury, that will go to the something else. So it won't be coming for the refund.
Exactly. I agree with
you, but, we wanted to raise one more point.
Oh. What is the second point you said?
Yeah, I want to say this tea promotion says. You are now charging 350. You have got 7 billion rupees with you. Nothing has been done about the promotion. Then if it is so, why are you still charging from the exporters when you have got so much money for the promotion and nothing has been done about it? So please reconsider.
Unfortunately, this committee does not have any official status.
Yeah, it does not have, but you have the
you
have the punch to present it to the right people.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.